You know what a mortgage is, but what about a reverse mortgage? Hello and welcome to Practical Personal Finance, where you get the information you need to understand and succeed with money. I'm Andrew Scheer, and a few years back, I heard someone talking about a reverse mortgage, and I thought to myself, how the heck does that work? Well, whether you're just a curious type like I am, or you're interested in learning more about reverse mortgages for the benefit of yourself or a family member, you've come to the right place. Today, I'm going to explain what a reverse mortgage is and how it works, the requirements to qualify for a reverse mortgage, and the three types of reverse mortgages. Make sure you stick around until the end when I'll give you my thoughts on reverse mortgages and whether or not I'd recommend using them. Remember to give this video a thumbs up. And if you're new here, hit that subscribe button. You're about to learn something new about money. Let's start off by talking about what a reverse mortgage is and how it works. A reverse mortgage is a type of loan that allows you to trade some of the equity in your home in exchange for cash. Remember that the equity you have in your home is just the amount your home is worth minus the amount you still owe if you have a mortgage. What makes a reverse mortgage different from many other loans is that there are no monthly payments. Instead, the total amount for the loan is due in full when you die or when you sell or move out. It's a lot like a home equity loan, but with one big payment at the end rather than smaller monthly payments along the way. The most common use of a reverse mortgage is to supplement your income during retirement. Lots of retired folks own their homes free and clear, but don't otherwise have much in the way of retirement savings. The reverse mortgage allows people like this to access some of that equity in their home while staying put in a home that they've probably owned and lived in for a long time. Depending on what type of reverse mortgage you get, that extra cash can be used for just about anything, from repairs and renovations to cars and vacations. When you get a reverse mortgage, you have three options for how you'll receive the funds. You can choose to receive the entire amount you're approved for up front in one lump sum payment, or you can elect to receive smaller, equal monthly payments for a certain number of years. Or you can use the reverse mortgage like a line of credit, withdrawing whatever amount you need, whenever you need it. The amount you can take out on a reverse mortgage varies based on a number of factors. Your lender will look at your age, the amount of equity you have in your home, and the amount you currently owe if you have a mortgage. In general, you'll be approved for a larger amount if you're older, you have a ton of equity, and you own the home free and clear. So far, I've made reverse mortgages sound pretty appealing. Cash in your pocket whenever you want, no payments, and you get to keep your home. Are there any negatives? Well, for starters, reverse mortgages aren't free. I know it might seem like free money, but just like any other lender, reverse mortgage lenders exist to make money. And they make it in a number of ways. Let's go over three of them. And remember, since you aren't making payments every month, all of these are simply added to your loan balance. Number one are your startup costs. Just like regular mortgages have closing costs, reverse mortgages have origination fees. Let's pretend that your origination fee was $5,000, and you'll be getting a $2,000 check every month. After your first month, you'll have an extra $2,000 in your bank account, but your reverse mortgage balance will already be $7,000, thanks to that origination fee. Number two are your monthly account maintenance fees. These might be small, like $40 or $50 per month, but they'll really add up over time. Number three are your interest fees. Reverse mortgages typically come with higher interest rates than regular mortgages. And because you're not making payments every month, you've got compound interest working against you. Not good. In addition to these three moneymakers for your lender, you'll also be required to purchase a special mortgage insurance policy to protect your lender from any eventual losses. So you can add that to your balance every month as well. One factor that is often overlooked by reverse mortgage recipients is that you're still responsible for paying your property taxes, homeowners insurance, and HOA dues. If you're used to paying a traditional mortgage, you might forget about these other expenses, especially the property taxes and homeowners insurance, because they're normally included in your monthly mortgage payment. With a reverse mortgage, though, you'll be responsible for paying those expenses out of pocket. And if you fail to pay, the reverse mortgage lender will foreclose on your home. This is a harsh reality that many Americans with reverse mortgages face every year. Reverse mortgages are typically repaid with the proceeds from the sale of your home, either by you if you decide to sell, or by your heirs if you live in the home until you die. In either case, a reverse mortgage is a non-recourse loan. This is a good thing. What it means is the maximum amount you or your heirs will need to pay the lender is the fair market value of your home. If the balance on the reverse mortgage happens to be more than the value of the home itself, that difference is covered. Remember that special mortgage insurance policy you paid for earlier? Bingo. And if the home sells for more than the reverse mortgage amount, then you or your heirs get to keep the extra profits. Now that you understand the basics of what a reverse mortgage is, let's talk about the requirements to qualify. And there are several requirements. Number one, you've got to be at least 62 years old. If you're younger than that, you're out. Number two, you must be a homeowner. If you don't own a home, you have no home equity to access. Number three, the home you wish to use for the reverse mortgage must be your primary residence. You have to live there at least 6 months out of the year. Vacation homes don't count. And number four, you must have a significant amount of equity in your home. It's ideal if you own your home free and clear. It's less ideal, though still feasible, if you have a small mortgage. But if you have less than 50% equity, you can count yourself out. If you qualify based on the factors I just discussed, you'll also need to meet with a reverse mortgage counselor who will help you understand all the details and make the best possible decision. Last but not least, let's talk about the types of reverse mortgages. There are three different types. Each type is a little bit different, but they all serve the same essential purpose that I described earlier. Number one is called a single-purpose reverse mortgage. This type of reverse mortgage is typically offered by state and local governments or by nonprofit organizations to people with a low income. The amount they'll lend you is generally small, and it can only be used for one purpose, hence the name. That purpose is decided upfront as part of the approval process, and it's generally something like property tax payments, home repairs, or homeowners insurance. When you think of a single-purpose reverse mortgage, think essentials. Number two is called a home equity conversion mortgage, or HECM. This is the most common type of reverse mortgage. It's federally insured by the United States Department of Housing and Urban Development, in case your lender were to declare bankruptcy. And the money you receive can be used for any purpose. Because the reverse mortgage is federally insured, there are limits on the amount you can borrow, but they're much higher than what you'll get with a single-purpose reverse mortgage. Number three is called a proprietary reverse mortgage, and it's essentially a reverse mortgage that's offered and backed by a private company. With this type, you lose the federally insured aspect, but you stand to gain additional lending power without the federally imposed limits. Proprietary reverse mortgages are a little more difficult to come by, but they're out there for people who want to borrow more. Whatever type you go with, you generally have something called a right of rescission. What this means is that when you sign for a reverse mortgage and decide that maybe it wasn't the best decision, you have 3 business days to call the deal off. That's right, you can reverse the reverse mortgage. So if you feel like you or a family member made a bad decision or got pressured into a bad deal, it might not be too late to back out unscathed. So what are my thoughts on reverse mortgages? Well, I can definitely see how they might seem like a useful tool, but I believe that they're a poor choice in the vast majority of situations. The primary reasons you're going to be looking at a reverse mortgage are because you're retired, you own a home that's worth a decent chunk of change, and you don't have enough income to maintain the lifestyle you want. Now, I'm not at that stage of life yet, so you'll have to forgive me if I'm being insensitive, but I feel that sometimes you just gotta own up to the fact that you can't afford something. That something might be a vacation, or a new car, or a house you've lived in for decades. Sometimes it's best to own the fact that you can't afford it and let go of it on your own terms. Now, if you're short a couple $100s per month for property taxes, or you need a few $1,000s to replace your roof and one of those single-purpose reverse mortgages from your local government or a nonprofit will close that gap, then go for it. But for anything more, I just wouldn't do it. That's my 2 cents anyway. What do you think of reverse mortgages? let me know in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, you might enjoy this other one where I weigh the pros and cons of cutting up your credit cards. Click right here to watch. And if you're not already a PPF subscriber, then click right here. Thanks for watching. I'm Andrew Scheer, and I'll see you next time.